हेलो, आई होप यू गाइस आर डूइंग योर प्रोजेक्ट। आई थिंक सो। ओके, तो आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग, राइट? तो टुडे वी आर गोना सी अबाउट द पिवट टेबल्स। ओके, सो सम ऑफ यू गाइस नो व्हाट इज पिवट टेबल, राइट? सो सम ऑफ देम डजंट नो बट ओके, सो pivot table is used to convert your vertical rows into your column. Okay, so we can convert the row values into column headings. Okay, so we can convert the row value into columns headings. Okay, so the pivot table used to make that change, right? So let's see. So pivot, we have two concepts. One is pivot and unpivot. Okay, so mostly we are using a pivot table. Okay, so pivot is that, right? So pivot and unpivot in SQL are two relational operators that are used to convert a table expression into another. Okay, so pivot in SQL is used when we want to transfer the data from row level to column level. Data means we can convert the data into columns name. Okay, so an unpivot, the simply opposite to the pivot table. Okay, so unpivot in SQL is used to when we want to convert data from column level to row level. Okay, so unpivot and unpivot are relational functions. Then are used to generate a multi-dimensional report. We can change the row value into column value and column value into row value. Okay, that is multi-dimensional. Okay, so this is pivot table. Pivot relation operator converts data from row level to column level, and pivot rotates a table valued expression by turning the unique values from one column in the expression into multiple column in the output. Okay, so it converts the one column values, okay, one column row values into the multiple columns. Okay, so multiple columns in the output. Using pivot operator, we can perform aggregate operation where we need to them. Okay, so if you want to calculate some of the subjects for student list, you can use pivot table. And if you want to count what are the customers or how many customers in some particular criteria like country-wise or city-wise, okay, you can use pivot table. Okay, so some of them already know what is pivot. Okay, so the pivot mostly used in Excel. Okay, so now we have a pivot in SQL. Okay, so let's see how to do that. And this is the pivot table syntax. Okay, it is simple. Okay, so they are typing more content in it. That's why it looks like a huge one. Okay, so don't worry, it is simple and we can easily solve it. Okay, first, and here you can see the query that produced the data. This one is main query. Okay, so we are giving the query is in the parenthesis. Okay, so after that we are calling a select non-pivot column. Non-pivot column means here some columns we have assigned, right? So some customer ID, customer name, or some columns. Okay, so we have assigned and we are going to use one or two columns for the pivot. Okay, we can use only one column values for pivot and another column for aggregation function. Okay, so if you are declaring three columns, we are using only two columns for pivot and aggregation function. The one column is extras, right? So we can use here the select non-pivoted column, and you can declare here that non-pivoted column, and after that first pivoted column means now you have declared some values, okay, in that particular column. You can declare some values as a column name, okay. So then you can give here after that, then here, so you have to give a pivot. Okay, so here you have to give the alias name for your data produced query. After that, you have to give pivot open and close bracket. Okay, so the here which column you are going to do aggregation function, you have to mention it here. Okay, and after that, use for. For means, so you are going to print something, right? You are going to aggregate something, and for the column values. Okay, so you have to mention it here. Okay, so this is aggregated, the column being aggregated, and for, then here which column you are going to make a columns headers. Okay, so column that contains the values that will become column headers, right? So after that, in here you have to mention what are the values. If the column has a 10, 100 or 1000 values also, okay, so you are going to give what are the columns you are going to make a column header. You can declare here. Okay, then you have to use square brackets in SQL. So if you are giving the any name in your square brackets, it assumed as a database name or a column name or a link name. Okay, then after that, here you have to close the parenthesis, then you have to give a alias name for the pivot. Okay, so and finally, if you need any where conditions or if you want to do any order by classes, you can give here. Okay, so okay, so here I'll show some columns. Okay, like name or name and date in attendance. Okay, and here I'm going to give Shankar, and here date some date 22, then here person and finish date 22. Okay, so I'm going to copy this. So here we have some data, right? So for two students, one is Shankar and one is Dinesh. Okay, so if you go take a manufacturing company or some companies, the employee attendance will inserted like this. Okay, so it adds a dates and also attendance. Okay, so this is the SQL format or some insertion format. Okay, so the company wants to know the attendance. Okay, so wants to know the attendance. Here we have to print the date. Okay, here we have to print the date into columns. Okay, like name and dates like 22, 21, looks like, so the last one is 18 and 19, 20, 21, 22. Okay, so the company managers wants to see like this. Okay, so we have to convert it, right? So convert and finish. So the company wants to see like this. So you can see the variance, right? So it is more easier to read, okay? And it is more toughable. Okay. So the reason for storing like this, okay? So we can't create more columns. Like we have to each time we are going to alter the table and we are going to give a table name and also give a data type for that. Okay, so the insertion query, it much easier compared to column creation in SQL. Okay, so we have to install or we have to insert our attendance data like this. Okay, so we can if we have 170 employees in my company, so I have to insert 170 data, ORL absent and ORL present in that. If the date is 22, I'm going to add 170 rows, okay, ORL present and ORL absent, okay, so with the data of 22. So and then I can easily convert the data like this, okay. So this is the pivot table. We can convert the data from here to there. Okay, this is pivot table, right? So do you have any doubts?
No.
Okay, so
tables. Okay, so I'm going to open, yeah, so databases ARC people. So first I'll do the pivot table for customers. Okay, so then after that we'll see, or I will create some attendance data in Excel, then feed create a table, then feed the data into the table, then we solve what we are seeing in that whiteboard. Okay, let's see. I'm going to grab the details from customers. I'm going to run this. So we have some data, right? So I'm going to count the customers. Count, so we have already saw that. Okay, so how many customers in US and USA, like country wise? Okay, we need to calculate customer ID and comma country, then what is invalid country. Yeah, so here we have to use group by, right? because we are counting the customer ID. So now you can see the data, how many customers in each country. Okay, so now we are going to do pivot for this query. Okay, so we don't need group by and also count.
Sir?
Yeah.
Why didn't we use parentheses for country, sir?
What? Can you
repeat? Why didn't we use parentheses for country, sir?
Why didn't you use parentheses for country? Yeah.
Parentheses for country. Customer, for only customer ID, we use the parentheses, no, sir. So yeah. Why not for country?
So here we are going to count the customer IDs, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that's why I am passing the customer ID field into count. That's all.
Okay, sir.
Like list conversion or uppercase conversion in a Python. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. And here we don't need the count and group by to do pivot table. Okay. Then this is your main code. Okay. It produces the data, right? And I'm going to give select star from, then just pass parenthesis. Okay. So I'm going to map this query into subquery. Okay, so the name. Here you have to give a name for that. Okay, so now I'm going to run this. So you get the same ones, same data. Okay, then after that, here you have to give pivot. Okay, then open and close parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis, you have to pass your aggregation function and which column you are going to create. Okay, you have to give here. And first, I'm going to count the customer ID. Okay, so customer ID. Then you have to give for which table? That means which column? Okay, for country column. And in what are the values you are going to use in country field? Okay, so I'm going to use USA, and here you have to pass the column or field values in square brackets. Okay, then I'm going to give Belgium, Germany. And also UK. Okay, that's all. And here you have to give a alias name for pivot table. I'm going to give B. That's all. So I'm going to run this. So what is there?
C capital and ID capital, na sir?
Here case sensitive is not proper.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Here we don't use parentheses for okay. Because we have not used any aggregation or functions here. Okay, so we have to give just the column name. That's enough. Okay, so I'm going to run this. So now we get the value. Okay, so what are the, that means we have converted the country values into column. Okay, so here USA has 13 and Belgium has 2 and Germany has 11 and UK has 7. Okay, So do you have any doubts? Yeah. So now I'm going to create some datas. Okay. So like student attendance or employee attendance. Okay. So I'm going to feed the data into a new table. After that, we will calculate what we seen in whiteboard. Okay. Previously we saw that, right? So here I'm going to give a name. Then attendance status, okay. Then after attendance date, okay. See here we have three field, okay. One is name, attendance, and attendance date, okay. So here I'm going to give some data. Shankar, Dinesh, Suresh. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 data. Okay, so in SQL we have to give the date like year, month, and date. Okay, that is date. Like 2020-07-30, like this. Okay, so you have to give the date like this. Okay, okay. So but here we are going to add the date in string form. Okay, so don't worry. And here we have some data, 13 to 27 data. Okay, so I need to pass this. Yeah. Okay. Then I'm going to copy this for different dates. Okay, so we'll take date from 17. Okay, the data goes here. B. We'll delete this. Okay, so now we have 5 students details. Okay, student attendance details from 13 to 17. Okay. So I'm going to feed these data into new table. Okay, so I'm going to feed these data into new table and we'll do the pivot. Okay. So first I'm going to create a new table. So I'm going to delete this. Then create table. Okay, and A. Key, that's the table name. So you can give what table name you want. Okay, So I'm going to first we'll give ID, and that is int, then not null, then identity. So identity is for automatically create the ID value from 1 to whatever or how many values we are going to insert, it increasing that. Okay, so it automatically increase, okay, the value in unique, like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 whatever. Okay, then comma, here I'm going to give name, and is for NVAR character, and that is maximum, comma, I'm going to copy this okay, so here attendance, status, parent character, and attendance, date, that's also another character. Okay, then in your project you will use date time format. You have to use date time format. Okay, so here so we have to just converting the value into column header. Okay, so while creating your sale order table, sale order database, you have to use a date time format for dates. Okay, next I'm going to create this. Yeah, so now we have created the table. So to check here I'm going to refresh my server. Yeah, and PRSC tables. So here we have 18 that's created, right? And here edit top 200 rows, then I'm going to copy from empty cell, because in 80 table we have given 4 columns, right? One is identity. Copy this. Okay, so now we have a 25 data. Okay, so 25 data. So from the data of 13 to 17. Okay, so let's check, select start from 18. From okay, so we have the data 25 data. Okay, so in 80 table. So now I'm going to convert the entire data into pivot. Okay, so first I need the columns, right? So first I need the column names, right? So I'm going to give attendance, okay, attendance, date, because I'm going to fetch the data from attendance date for column creation. Okay, so attendance date from 80. So I'm going to run this. Now you can see here we have some duplicate values, right? So here I'm going to give distinct. So now we get the value from 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay. And here, so we need to give square bracket from front to end. So here to here, there. Okay, so by giving the, we can add some string concatenation here. Okay, so like double quote, double single quotes, and inside the single quotes, I'm going to pass this, just give plus, then here give plus, then square brackets. Then after that, we need commas for separating that column values. Okay, so that's why I'm giving comma. So we can get the format. Okay, then so I'll copy this. Okay, so here I'm going to create. So first step is data produce. Okay, so we have to do data fetching query. And here I'm going, I need only three columns, right? Name and data, that is attendance date, status, and also attendance date. Okay, so first I'm going to give from 80. Then here I'm going to give the columns what I want. First I want name, comma, and attendance underscore status, in comma, attendance underscore date. Okay, from 80. Okay, then so you need to give one more select statement for fetching the data from pivot and your original query. Select start from here. Okay, then after that here you have to give pivot and open and close brackets. Then so now we need to print the attendance status, right? Okay, so here we can't do any aggregation function here, because attendance status is strings, okay? That is NY character format, right? But we can use maximum minimum function. So maximum minimum also aggregate function, but we can use maximum for strings, okay? So here I give maximum, then I'm going to pass attendance underscore status, okay? So okay, done. And after that you have to give for, then what column you are going to make a column header. Okay, you have to give here attendance underscore date. Okay, and in, then you have to pass the column values. Like I'm going to copy this. Just here I'm going to pass the value. That's all. Okay, so now we get the column values, right? And here just mention the name. So I'm going to give B. Okay, then if you want order, you can give here. So I'm going to give order by name. Okay, so just run this. So now we have some error. Okay, from arrow 6. Okay, and here let me go from and our table name is 80, right? Yeah. And so I'm going to change this because at is the operator. Okay, so I'm going to change this just 81. Yes. Okay, now the table name has changed it. And here I'm going to give 81. So we'll check this. Is there a select start from 81? Okay. Name, attendance status. In attendance. Date. Okay. So here I have to open the bracket, right? So we have one more error. What is it? Yeah, here we need to remove the comma. So now we get the answer. I'm going to delete this query. So now we get the answer, right? So we have converted the column values into column headers. Okay. So now you can see the name has returned in order, in ascending order, and we can see the data's 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, so we can also see the attendance status. Okay, so from this data we have converted into like this. Okay, so do you have any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
And this is static pivot table type. Okay, so static means, so in each time we are going to give some data headings. Okay, so we have to mention the column heading, right? This is static. Okay, so this will not work for taking reports, because in each day, so we have to give attendance, right? So if you're taking a student attendance system or employee attendance system, we have to give attendance in each day. Okay, so for that we have to give, or we have to type the date for each day. Okay, so that is little bit tough, right? So we have one more option, that is dynamic pivot table. Okay, so dynamic is used to automatically fetch the column values and converted the column value into column headers. That is dynamic pivot table. Okay, so we will see on tomorrow what is dynamic pivot table. Okay, then so do you have any doubts, please text me, or do you face any difficulties while developing your project? Please text me. Okay, and thank you all.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.